Show some interest, some real interest.
14.25%.
Who's paying it?
McIntyre Credit.
How do we get it?
Investing.
What do we get? Where?
McIntyre Credit.
When?
By the month, the quarter.
Or half yearly.
What do you need to get 14.25%?
The prospectus from McIntyre Credit.
How did Antenny prepare for the tragic farewell of Molly Jones in the country practice? Find out only in this week's TV Week. There's the inside story of the Aussie TV beauty who snubbed America's Soapy King. Susan Sangster tells exclusively of her bid to find a new life on television. And award-winning Aussie star Norman Kay speaks about his private hell. Only in TV Week. We reveal Paul Young's surprise love bam, plus there's a mighty Paul Young pin-up, and you could win a $50,000 Porsche, a trip for two to America, or a Beatles video pack in our contest bonanza. It's all in this week's TV Week. Act with great family entertainment.
It's a world of new horizons, a world that's so exciting, with M&M's and friends to make the fun times last.
M&M's milk chocolates, delicious full cream milk chocolate covered with a thin crisp shell. So the milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
All the world loves M&M's full cream milk chocolate joy for everyone.
M&M's, the milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
We beat a good side, we're a better side.
Courage and determination. West's had it when they downed Penrith. 8:30 tonight, only the might of Balmain stands in the way of their place in TEN's National Panasonic Cup Final.
The star of our show, Greg Evans!
Thank you for that, and welcome to Perfect Match, everybody in the studio and to you two at home, wherever you may be, right around the country. Thanks for joining us tonight. Another bit of fun, and to tell us about our first three fellas, here's Debbie.
You've got the Perfect Match magazine.
I have the Perfect Match magazine.
Mm-hmm.
And it's fantastic. It's got everything you want to know about the show. And
actually, it has, and it's available in your newsagent now. There you can see. Oh, look, there's a picture of you and Christopher. It's in response to a lot of letters that we've been getting about the behind the scenes of Perfect Match. There's a couple that were on our show. It tells you their story, what they felt on the show and what's happened to them since. And there's pictures of our crew here and just about all the behind the scenes. I didn't know that was in it. Dexter being fed. That's a very oil change and grease. Anyway, have a look for it in your newsagent now, the Perfect Match magazine.
Yes.
Deb, tell us about these three fellas, please.
All right, our first contestant is an aircraft engineer who wants a lady he can take anywhere, Steve Paddo Pattinson. Hi, Steve. Welcome to the show. Next, we have a mining engineer who likes hang gliding, Paul Kennelly. Hi, Mr. Kennelly. Nice to see you. And last but not least, a carpenter who enjoys drawing. Tom Partner. Hello, Tom.
Interesting guys.
Thank you.
Bye. Love your earrings, too.
Thank you.
Number one, if you could have a date with any woman in the world, who do you reckon you might date?
Oh, I'd definitely have to go with Sheena Rusin, I'd say. She's
why?
Gorgeous, talented, and she could probably afford to pay for the date.
No deal this dog. Number two.
It'd have to be Pamela Stevenson.
Oh, why?
Well, she's lovely to look at. She'd be fun to be with, and I like the way she wears her hair.
Fun to be with, indeed. She's a zany lady. Number three.
Debbie Newson, yeah.
Oh, Deb, come back here. Yeah, all right, good luck to you fellas. Thanks for joining us. Welcome to our show. Now, backstage, we don't have Debbie for you, number three, but we do have a beautiful girl. Max, tell us all about her, please.
Great Greg, our first lovely single tonight's an art student who would like to have been a queen in ancient Egypt. It's Renee Stevens.
I'm wonderful. How are you?
Fine.
You look terrific.
Thank
and you're
you.
A student. Whereabouts are you studying?
I'm studying in Newcastle.
What are you doing there?
Bachelor of Arts.
Mm-hmm. What would you like to do when you finish?
I'd like to be a teacher eventually, once I've done the Dip Ed.
Yes. And what subject would you like to teach?
Art.
Art?
Mm-hmm.
You're an arty sort.
Yeah, I hope I am.
What sort of a guy are you looking for, Renee?
Well, you tell me what's behind the screen and I'll let you know.
No, can't do that, but you can find out with a series of questions. Have a seat, Renee. In fact, that's what we want you to do. Ask some questions to these blokes to try and determine which one is just perfect for you. Renee, first question to number one, please.
Contestant number one. If you were to be a cross between two people, who would you choose?
I'd choose Tom Selleck and Rodney Rood.
What sort of a combination do you reckon you'd end up with?
Well, you'd end up with a good-looking, suave guy with charm, personality, good sense of humour, and you'd get to do the shopping in the Ferrari.
Number two, if you could be a cross between any two people, who would you choose?
Graham Kennedy and Tony Packard.
They'd do it right for you, would they?
Oh, well, when you finish making a fool of yourself on TV, at least you can go home and laugh about it.
That's for sure.
Number three.
Mel Gibson and Clint Eastwood, Green.
Why?
Oh, just their characters, their charisma.
Good. Renee, which of which of those combinations appeals to you?
Well, I do like Mel Gibson, so I'll go for number three.
Number three. Gets the first match with Renee, and your next question, please, for contestant number two.
Contestant number two, when do you find it hard to hold back your feelings?
Tearful farewells at airports usually get the best of me.
Cry as you fly, do you? Number three.
When I'm having my toes licked, Greg.
Wait, sorry?
When I'm having my toes licked.
Oh, charming. Number one, when do you find it hard to hold back your feelings?
Oh, I really love having my back scratched.
Renee.
Well, the tearful farewell sounds good, so I'll go for number two.
You'll go for number two. I just found it very hard to hold back asking number two twice. Next question, number three, please.
Okay, contestant number three. If you were to serenade the girl, what's the one thing you made sure you wouldn't do?
Oh, I'd try to make sure I wouldn't sing the wrong name.
Yeah. Like Bruce or something like that. Number one, if you were to serenade a girl, what's the one thing you're sure you wouldn't do?
I'd try not to stutter.
Number two.
I'd make sure I'd pick the right song. I wouldn't sing Love Me, Love My Dog or anything like that.
Renee, well, how would you
I wouldn't do what number two said he wouldn't do, so I'll go for number two again.
You would. You would do what he said he wouldn't do, and that's two matches to number two, one match to number three, and 10 seconds for you to decide who is your perfect match. Righto, Bachelor of Arts student. Tell us what you're thinking.
Well, I'm thinking I'll probably go for number two.
Yeah. Number two wins the date with Renee. Contestant number one is an aircraft engineer. Renee, I'd like you to meet Stephen Pattinson.
Hello.
Contestant number three is a carpenter who enjoys drawing. This is Tom Partner.
Hello, Tom. How are you?
Contestant number two is your date, Renee. Down to the heart, please, number two. Why did you go for number two?
Two matches?
Two matches, I think, would be the main reason, yeah.
Went with the odds. Fingers crossed.
Okay, he's a mining engineer, and he likes hang gliding.
He loves daydreaming. He likes beautiful ladies. He's got one.
Renee Stevens, please meet Paul Kennelly. You just said, are you nervous? Are you happy?
Yes.
Very good.
Excited?
Happy.
Like the look of the lady? Like the look of the man?
They do, certainly do.
Got a lot of time to look at each other. This weekend, you're both off to the Gold Coast.
Fantastic.
Surfers Paradise is the nightlife unmatched anywhere and set in the heart of Australia's entertainment capital is the famous Chevron Paradise Hotel, featuring three swimming pools, a heated spa, a variety of restaurants and bars, and every amenity you could wish for. You can party on until the sun fades in the night sky. After dark, enjoy the best night spot in town with a champagne supper at Paul Allen's Melba's on the Park. Enjoy the ultimate resort, the Chevron Paradise Hotel.
Oh, look, beautiful spot. And you'll enjoy your time at Melba's. I often go there and it's a lovely spot. Have a nice meal there and a bit of a dance.
Now, If you are the perfect match, both of you get this as a bonus prize.
For the perfect match, timepieces of ultimate style and distinction. The Jubilee design, comprising scratch-proof sapphire, crystal and classic styling. Brado from Hourglass Jewellers.
Brené, if I might say, this is a lovely dress that you have.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, really. Did you design it or anything?
No, I went out and picked it myself, though.
Did you? That's nice. You happy?
Very happy.
Let's find out if they're the perfect match as we welcome to our show tonight the man with the robot with the statistics, says Dexter.
Seeing the future because your perfect match with a compatibility score of 72% is Stephen Pattinson.
Stephen was the perfect match.
Bad luck.
Bad luck, Steve. Good luck, Paul. Have a nice time on the Gold Coast, both of you. Thanks
Thank
for
you.
Being on our show. After this break, we'll return with a couple who have just come back from Noosa.
When Tim got his freedom, he got everything he wanted in one account. Tim can use his St. George Freedom account any day or night.
That's freedom.
And the interest goes up and up, the more he saves. Up to 11.25%.
What a great idea, St. George.
Freedom's everything you want in one account.
What a great idea, St. George.
If you think golden crumpets are the greatest, wait till you try golden wholemeal crumpets. Delicious crumpets with the goodness of wholemeal. Add your favorite toppings to golden wholemeal crumpets for a hearty snack, a light lunch, or a tasty supper.
To taste golden good like a crumpet should, it's got to be golden.
Now with the choice of wholemeal, golden crumpets, golden good.
At Woolworths Supermarkets, your family's shopping dollar goes a lot further during our Dollar Day Sale. Rush in now for brilliant family savings with Dollar Day Sale specials like these.
Whole sides of lamb, $14. Bird's Eye frozen peas, 3 for $2, save 79 cents. Nine Lives cat food, 5 for $2, save 40 cents. Campbell's soups, 3 for $2, save 28 cents. Pinoclean varieties, 4 for $3, save 88 cents.
Woolies' brilliant Dollar Day Sale, now on at your Woolworths Supermarket. Hurry!
What now, Johnson?
The cream of chicken soup, sir.
Fresh seasoned chicken.
But you're putting everything in at once.
Saves time.
Saves time. Johnson, Campbell's superb soups are made by adding the right ingredients at precisely the right time. First,
prepare your stock. Then, add the chicken.
And later,
seasoning.
Campbell's Soups. If we compromised, it wouldn't taste like Campbell's. And now introducing the Campbell's Soups Cookbook with over 350 tasty new recipes.
If you thought you had a bad day, staggering through the obstacle course of life, scaling problems the size of cliffs, trying to work miracles like walking on water, seesawing from one disaster to another, or else struggling for balance on the tightrope of reality, console yourself with this one thought. Is life not just a game? It's a knockout. Proudly sponsored by Uncle Toby's, tonight at 7:30 on Channel 10.
On Perfect Match, you just saw Renee choose Paul. They're off to the Gold Coast this weekend. If you would like to be on our show and have as much luck as these two, all you have to do is what Max says.
True, Greg. It's loads of fun and as simple as this. Send a stamped self-addressed envelope to Perfect Match contestant, GPO Box 4204, Sydney, New South Wales 2001.
Thank you. Welcome back to Perfect Match. A bit of fun, though, as we bring these two back. I think he's in love with her. Victoria Spring and Greg Reeves are the two that I refer to. Here they are when they first met on the show. Look, Victoria looks stunning. Greg looks great. They both met. Victoria chose Greg. And they were the perfect match. To get to know each other better, we sent them off to fabulous Noosa. I know what you're all thinking. And don't they look fantastic together, having a good time in the pool. And a little bit of windsurfing as well. Looks like as if they really got to know each other. Look at this. Mind you, they were duds at windsurfing at all. It's not as easy as it looks, is it? All right, let's bring them back and find out how that date went. Victoria and Greg. Can I call you Vicky? Thank you.
Hello.
Thank you for that. Hello. How are you, Greg? Nice to see you again. What did you think of Natanya?
I loved Natanya, Greg. It was fantastic. Spa in every room. It was really luxurious.
Did you use yours?
We did, Greg, yes.
We did, Greg. Yes. I see. Vicky, what's this about Greg leaving your room holding a toothbrush in his hand?
Oh, that was totally innocent. He came in to borrow my toothpaste early in the morning.
And then in the afternoon, the soap and then the shampoo and then...
That's my story. I'm sticking to
so
it.
So did you have a good time together?
Yes, we did. Yeah, we got to know each other really well. Yeah.
Oh, when these two returned, we took them aside separately to find out a few probing questions. We started by asking them to tell us what Vicky is like.
Oh, she's a bit of a wild lady. She's, she can't be controlled at all.
Oh, you like guys with muscles because they make you feel small and helpless.
She always gets what she wants too. She knows her talents and she'll always go for what she wants.
And what sort of a guy is Greg?
Greg is a yes man. I think I could get him to do anything. I know I could, he's told me.
She uses her looks very well.
We had everything in common, perhaps a bit too much. We're probably both as naughty as each other.
I think it was a perfect weekend. I think that we were as close as you can get to a perfect match.
Well, was the weekend perfect for romance?
No, he was definitely a bit scared of me, I think. I think I was a bit too outgoing. But I expected him to do more.
We all carked it after dinner at about 11 o'clock. But yes, there was a little bit of romance.
If I had to change Greg, I'd definitely make him more aggressive. I think he'd accomplish a lot more.
She makes me feel masculine. She makes me feel like a man.
He made the first move. He was pretty eager. He just couldn't follow it through.
So how does the future look for this couple?
Oh, we'll see each other again, that's for sure.
I hope he keeps trying.
So she makes you feel like a man, hey, Greg?
She did.
Now, what's this, you know, you will see each other only if he keeps trying? Do you really think it's the man's place to keep trying?
Yes, I do. I'm a bit old-fashioned.
So if he doesn't keep trying, you're prepared to let the relationship lapse?
I'll just put it on ice for a while.
What?
The relationship.
And are you going to keep trying, Greg?
I'm sure, yeah. I'll keep going.
I tend to think you're very fond of this lady.
I'm attracted to her.
And your reaction to that?
I'm flattered.
Good. So are you going to stick together?
Yeah, we're going to stick together.
I think we might for a while.
Yeah. All right, for coming back, here's a gift for you both.
Yes, Victoria and Greg, for a chance to recharge your batteries. Either an energetic activity or just plain relaxing, spend 5 days with a partner of your choice at the Solar Springs Health and Fitness Country Club.
See, now you've won that prize individually. You can take it wherever you like. I want to know whether you're going to go together.
Yeah.
Oh, terrific. All right, I love it when a plan works out. We'll thank you for joining us. We'll take a break and we'll be right back with more of our show in just a moment.
Police identify the two murder victims found at Mount Kembla. A school burns for the second time in 2 days and an historic venture underway. These and more in Eyewitness News at 6 here on 10 right after Perfect Match.
Here's an offer you've just got to try.
McDonald's for chicken with a free thigh.
With every two or three piece pack of chicken and french fries,
you get a free thigh.
And that's no lie.
A delicious,
succulent,
tender thigh.
Free with every two
or three piece pack
of McChicken
and french fries you buy.
This offer is for a limited time.
So you better fly.
If you want to try
McDonald's McChicken with a free fries.
Thigh.
Free thigh.
You are about to discover the secret of the perfect chip. New polyunsaturated flora oil. A beautifully light oil that does a perfectly wonderful thing. It crisps the outside of the food quickly, sealing without sogging, so the flavor of the food is locked on the inside. The result, beautifully crisp outside, beautiful flavor inside. New polyunsaturated flora oil, the secret of better taste.
When you got Levi's, the legend you know, from the patch in your hip to the boots on your toes. When you got Levi's, you're always gonna win. You don't need another thing. Look at those Levi's. Now you can tell they're more than just tough, they're a legend as well. Levi's, you got a legend. When you got Levi's, you got a legend.
Cherry ripe.
Crunchy. Picnic. Now 10% bigger, same price.
Fantastic.
Now 10% bigger cherry ripe.
Mm-mm.
10% more of that big cherry taste.
Delicious.
Now 10% bigger crunchy.
Wow.
10% more of that crisp golden honeycomb.
Great.
Now 10% bigger picnic.
Terrific.
10% more of that big nutty taste.
Delicious.
Now 10% bigger cherry ripe crunchy picnic.
Same price.
From Cadbury. Buy some today.
Tonight's unmatched guys will receive the stylish compendium complete with calculator and 22-carat gold-plated pen from Papermate, and for the girls, a selection of fine perfumes and toiletries for today's woman from Fabergé. And they'll all receive a gift box of the finest quality chocolates, the Cabaret selection from Red Tulip Chocolates.
Sorry, no, forgive me. Tell us about these three ladies, please, Deb.
Our first contestant is into playing soccer, Greg. Say hello to Joanne JJ Orlando.
Hi, JJ. Welcome to the show.
Next, we have a travel receptionist who doesn't like gossip, Sonia Blackwell. Hi, Sonia. Nice to see you. And a bank clerk who is dying to go to Greece. Welcome, Rhonda Forrest. Hi, Rhonda.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you for this.
Good luck.
Mm-hmm. Hello, number one. What's your favourite song?
Hi. Itsy Wincy Teeny Weeny Yellow Polka Dot Bikini.
Oh, yes. Sure, we can't talk you out of that.
No, that's
number
right.
Number two, what's your favourite song?
Easy Lover by Phil Collins.
Easy Lover. Thank goodness the single can't hear. Number three, what's your favourite song?
You Should Have Known Better by...
Should Have Known Better. All right, big hand for these three ladies, please. Welcome to our show. Max, tell us about the man backstage.
Terrific, Greg. Our second single tonight's an auditor who loves bushwalking, hiking, abseiling and rafting. It's Philip Spender.
G'day, Flip.
G'day, Greg. How are you?
I'm good.
You well?
Yeah,
couldn't be better.
Philip and I were chatting out the back before, and you have a wonderful story about your 21st birthday. Tell us. It's funny.
Well, before my 21st, a couple of guys and I, we were together, and we were talking about what a fun time we could have with a lady. Anyway, the suggestion came up about a bath full of jelly. Well, for ending up for my 21st, I got 187 boxes of jelly, which I've still got.
You can't. When was your 21st?
Oh, a couple of years ago now.
187 boxes of stale jelly.
Have a seat.
Thanks,
good man. Luck to you. We might give you a chance to use that jelly, actually. Philip, you know the rules. First question and number one, please.
Contestant number one. What do you find is the best way to get a conversation started with a guy?
To open my mouth and speak.
And say, what's your favourite flavour of jelly? Number two.
I'd say, parlez-vous français?
Oh, that gets a guy to speak, does it?
Mm-hmm.
Lay a bit of French on him. Number three. What do you think is the best way to get a conversation started with a guy?
I'd start by walking over and saying hi, good looking.
Pardon?
I'd start walking over and saying hi, good looking.
Hi, good looking. Philip?
Well, Greg, I fall into the good looking category, so I'd have to take contestant number three.
No flies on Flip. Next question, Philip, to contestant number two, please.
Contestant number two, over the years, how has your opinion of men changed?
It's changed rapidly. Some are good, some are bad, but I hope you're great.
Yeah, he's great. Number three, over the years, how has your opinion of men changed?
When I was young, they were small. Now I'm older, they got bigger and better.
Number one.
Well, when I was five, I used to play with them. When I was 10, I hated them. When I was 15, I discovered them. And now I'm older, I know I'm better.
Philip.
I'd have to go for number two, Greg.
Contestant number two. She just hopes that you're great. Sometimes he's great. Philip, next question number three, please.
If you became a man for 24 hours, what is the first thing you'd do?
I think I'd walk into a men's all-night club and find out what happens.
A men's all-night club. Number one.
Well, the first thing I'd definitely do is take off my dress and put on a pair of pants and shirt.
Right. And number two, if you're a man for 24 hours, what's the first thing that you'd do?
I'd take a lady out and show her how she should be treated.
Philip, if you're a man for 24 hours, what's the first thing? No, I guess you'd have to transpose that, wouldn't you? If you were a woman for 24 hours, which of those answers would you relate to? Putting on a pair of pants, says Philip.
Oh, I reckon, yeah, I'd take off my dress and put on some pants.
That was contestant number one. All right, you've had one match each with those three ladies. Philip, we're now going to give you 10 seconds to think about who you'd like for your date.
It's a tough decision, Greg. It really is. Number one.
Yeah! Number one! Philip, contestant number two is a travel receptionist. Please meet Sonia Blackwell.
Hello.
Meet Philip. Contestant number three is a bank clerk. I'd like you to meet Rhonda Forrest.
Hi, Rhonda.
Philip, contestant number one. Like that, do you, Philip?
Yeah,
contestant number one's your date down to the hard line. Here we go. Arrange this and conduct what you have. Match a piece, it is her, you're right. Why did you pick number one?
I've got no idea, Greg.
She's a student. She hates guys who try to pick you up as soon as they meet you.
She loves parties anyway. Philip Spencer, Spender, please meet Joanne JJ Orlando.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
That's a hard decision there.
JJ?
Hi.
For you two this weekend, you're both off to Townsville.
That's correct, Philip and Joanne. You'll both enjoy and surpass style and luxury when you stay at the Townsville International. Featuring spacious modern rooms and top facilities, you can relax by a rooftop swimming pool, sip cocktails and Rogue's piano bar, and then dine in the elegant Margot restaurant. Then climb aboard for a trip of a lifetime as you explore one of the world's unique wonders, the world's Great Barrier Reef. From the Yellow Submarine, you'll marvel at this underwater paradise. Compliments are Reef Link and the Townsville International.
Philip Spender. He's a big spender, too, isn't he?
He is. He looks like a big spender.
He does. You're about to find out in town. What a lovely gift for your first date.
Yeah, great.
We might be able to give you some bonus gifts if Philip here has done the right thing and chosen his perfect match. We'll find that out immediately following this break.
Two Sydney men charged with wildlife violations. The full story in Eyewitness News coming up next.
As well, we take you to the start of a young woman's historic adventure.
And the uncanny X-Men jeopardise their careers with an obscenity conviction.
These are new Kentucky Nuggets from Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Tender pieces of boneless chicken cooked golden light, the Colonel's special way. I like mine dipped in a sauce, barbecue or sweet and sour.
I prefer mine without sauce, actually, to really savour the Colonel's chicken.
I like them with sauce.
Oh, without sauce.
When?
Without.
I like them
new
with sauce.
New Kentucky Nuggets from Kentucky Fried Chicken. Tender pieces of boneless chicken in packs of 6, 12 and 18. You can have them with or without. With.
At Woolworths Supermarkets, your family's shopping dollar goes a lot further during our Dollar Day Sale. Rush in now for brilliant family savings with Dollar Day Sale specials like these.
Whole sides of lamb, $14. Bird's Eye frozen peas, 3 for $2, save 79 cents. Nine Lives cat food, 5 for $2, save 40 cents. Campbell's soups, 3 for $2, save 28 cents. Pinocleen varieties, 4 for $3, save 88 cents.
Woolies brilliant Dollar Day Sale, now on at your Woolworths Supermarket. Hurry!
Norman Ross guarantee to beat any competitor's advertised price on anything we sell. But when it comes to carpeting your home, one of your biggest investments, you want more than just the lowest price. You also want the reassurance of dealing with experts. At Norman Ross, you get a choice of all the leading brands, plus unbiased expert advice and truly professional laying. Why pay specialty or department store prices for your carpet and floor coverings? Put Norman Ross to the test. We guarantee to beat any competitor's advertised price on anything we sell.
If you love chalky biscuits, taste my Weston's Choc Fruit Bar. A munchy, bumpy biscuit piled with fluffy mallow, heaps of peanuts sprinkled with raisins, and yummy chalky stuff all over. Delicious.
Weston's make them good, good as they can be. Everybody loves a better biscuit
from the Better Biscuit Bakery.
There are plenty of reasons to be home tonight. Right after the news, it's MASH, and the madness continues with It's a Knockout. Then Balmain play Wests in the National Panasonic Cup. followed by Sean Connery in The Offence.
Welcome back to Perfect Match. Philip here has chosen Joanne. If you two are the perfect match, you both win. This is a bonus.
Yes, Philip and Joanne, follow the fun and action with a disco, robo, the portable one with a party partner, with built-in FM tuner, cassette player, and special effects. Good times for all from Pioneer Electronics.
Would be great. It's probably, the closest thing to Dexter's Perfect Match you'll ever find, one of those things. All right, your compatibility, as according to our computer. Here's Dexter to tell us.
Oh, dear sir, you may have a few mountains to climb, because your perfect match with a compatibility score of 70% is Sonia Blackwell.
Sonia, the perfect match. Well, Philip, Townsville this weekend with Joanne. Does that make you happy?
Sure does, Greg.
If you're happy, we're happy. Good. Everybody's happy, and on that note, we'll say goodnight to you. Debbie and Dexter?
Well, we'll see you all later. Night, Greg.
Bye-bye.
Thanks for joining us. Bye-bye for now.
We use Chris Brothers and Oodles for professionals. Hair care products by Willow. Greg Evans Clothes by John Roach. Available from Dennis and Wright. Oval Male Fashion Forest Hill.
Australia's budding pop stars, the Uncanny X-Men, today put their forthcoming overseas tour in jeopardy with an obscenity conviction. That story in Eyewitness News, just a few moments away.
This has been a Grundy television production in association with Network 10 Australia. Thanks for listening.
Australia.